So here's another fun one, EMPs. So at first this video was going to be just about EMPs and how they work, but then I remembered that Black Panther, which came out just a little while ago, had a few scenes which used a similar piece of technology, EMP discs. So instead of my originally planned video about EMPs, let's talk a little bit more about Black Panther's EMP discs, and don't worry, the original script is still in play. First off, what is an EMP? An electromagnetic pulse, or EMP, is possibly one of the most dangerous things out there, and at the same time it can be a very fun science experiment. Looking at it objectively, someone could use a huge EMP blast to shut down an entire city or even an entire country. But let's slow down a bit and talk about a few things. Electromagnetic pulse. An electromagnetic field, also EMF or EM field, is a physical field produced by electronically charged objects. It affects the behavior of charged objects in the vicinity of the field. The field can be viewed as a combination of an electric field and a magnetic field. The electric field is produced by stationary charges and the magnetic field by moving charges or currents. These two are often described as the sources of the field. I'm not going to get overly technical here, but this is one of the things that you should first understand. Now that we have a simplified understanding of the electromagnetic part of an EMP, let's talk about EMPs themselves. Currently, when EMPs are spoken of, most people gravitate towards the idea of nuclear bombs and nuclear explosions. And while they are not exactly wrong to think so, there's actually a lot more to EMPs than just that. Electromagnetic pulses occur when a rapidly accelerating current generates a magnetic field that causes a burst of electromagnetic energy. Commonly caused by lightning strikes, EMPs can cause power outages and even damage electronics by short-circuiting them. Theoretically speaking, there are many good uses of EMPs as well as bad ones. We can use EMP generators to shut down malfunctioning technology devices. So for example, if a train is going out of control because the control system is not working, we can use an EMP to shut down the entire system and make it easier to stop the train. And that's just one. When thinking of the term, the user is more dangerous than the weapon, this is one area that we should really focus on. While an EMP can be dangerous to electronics due to natural forces, in the hands of a man it can be even deadlier. Now, how do the EMP discs from Black Panther work? Well, they're actually not all that different from actual EMP tech in real life. These are tremendously effective tools and both shut down vehicles and render communications inoperative. We first see them in the opening fight scene with T'Challa tossing one onto car engines. The disc appears to adhere to the car's surface magnetically and likely uses some form of flux compression system. Black Panther uses them to strand his targets and neutralize them without them being able to call for reinforcements. Perhaps the most remarkable aspect of this disc is the short range of the EMP. In the real world, although non-nuclear EMPs generally have a smaller range, it's nothing like this kind of scale. Wakanda has effectively micro-engineered a technology that's one step beyond modern science. One of the more interesting uses of these EMP discs is in the chase scene with T'Challa and Shuri, when T'Challa latches onto a vehicle and Shuri manages to get control over it all the way in Wakanda. The actual application is explained a bit more in a recent video from the Vanity Fair YouTube channel, and essentially it can be placed on any vehicle and it would enable the user to gain control of it through a sand table in Shuri's lab. It would take form of the car seat to enable her to control it remotely while seeing where she's driving. A similar control scene can be seen later on in the movie, and I could probably assume that a similar technique is used. As for the projection tech that allows the shape of the vehicle to be seen, it seems that Shuri's lab contains a sophisticated hologram generator as part of a remote driving or piloting system. The most likely explanation is that it's a combination of holograms and ultrasonics. Sound waves can be modulated to create a physical force, and vibranium allows precise manipulation of ultrasonic frequencies. In the comics, this ability has traditionally been associated with Claw. Getting back to the main point here, no matter how fun and useful the movie makes EMP tech seem, it can be dangerous in real life. Nuclear blasts can trigger EMPs. Given the size of the blast, this EMP can disrupt or even destroy electronics from miles away. The tech in the movie is a bit more localized and controlled than what we have in real life. There's extreme control over what happens when the tech is activated. Now finally for this video, how exactly were EMPs invented or discovered? The fact that an EMP is produced by a nuclear explosion was known since the very first days of nuclear weapons testing. That dates back to over 73 years ago in 1945, but the magnitude of the EMP and the significance of its effects were not realized for some time. During the first United States nuclear test in 1945, electronic equipment was shielded due to Enrico Fermi's expectation of an electromagnetic pulse from the detonation. A condensed summary of the next couple of years would be that testing was done continuously both in private and public areas. Also, there were many attempts to develop non-nuclear EMP generators. The concept of the explosively pumped flux compression generator for generating a non-nuclear electromagnetic pulse was conceived as early as 1951 by Andrei Sakharov in the Soviet Union, but nations have usually kept their most recent work on non-nuclear EMP highly classified until the technology was old enough as similar ideas were widely conceived by physicists in other nations. There are a number of different types of non-nuclear EMP generators, but all of them have extremely limited range compared to nuclear EMP. As for now, this is where I end today's video. Also, I have put a link down in the description below for a little bit of recommended reading on the history of EMPs. I recommend that you check that out. It should be really useful. If you enjoyed the video, learned anything new or want more, feel free to click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to be notified whenever a new video is released. Leave a like and comment your thoughts below. If you are feeling generous and want to help this channel out in producing better content, consider supporting this channel on Patreon. A dollar goes an extremely long way. The link is in the description. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed, and I will be seeing you in the next video.